Hello everybody, I am Schmitty300, I am the Pure Gamer, welcome home, and welcome to Super Mega Baseball Extra Innings. So, right off the top, this is not easy for me to say. I've been a fan of video games of all sorts since I was, you know, knee high, and I've been steadfast in the fact that I felt that Baseball Stars for the Nintendo, the NES, is the greatest baseball game ever developed. Even though it's an antique now, I still think it has been the best. Until now. Brian, I'm looking at you. I'm sorry, man. This is the best baseball game that's ever been developed. It's the most well-rounded, best. I can't even say enough about it. We'll get into it in detail and I'll show you all about it, but this is the best. We're gonna just dive into it here. I don't even know where to start explaining things. So, I've been playing this for well over a year now, I think. There's a sequel in development coming out in the middle of this year, which I'm very excited to play. One great thing about this game, which is kind of a little icing on all the cake, is that the developers are actually in the city I live in. They're just downtown, and I went and saw them a couple months ago and kind of did a little bit of fanboy stuff, which was kind of embarrassing and unexpected, but it was interesting. They're such they're an amazing group of guys. Mostly guys, couple girls, just a little office downtown. Probably 8 or 9 of them. Fantastic group of people. Welcome me in with open arms. They didn't expect visitors. They're just awesome. If you're a fan of video game baseball, buy this game. It's worth every penny. I know it's on Xbox One, Xbox 360, and on Steam. I'm pretty sure it's on PS4. I know for a fact that the sequel will be on PS4, Xbox One, and Steam. But I think this one's on Xbox. I know it's on Xbox 360 because I've seen it there before. I think this is on PS4. But the physics of the baseball itself is the best. How they work the hitting and the pitching is phenomenal. And I'm going to show you all about it. But it's... Sorry, Baseball Stars. You had 2 decades in my head. Plus, you had 25 years of being the best in my head. And you've been trumped. Oh, I can't believe I just used that. Ugh, sorry. So, we're gonna dive into it here. So, as you can see in the top right, I'm level 81, which I've been playing this for quite a while. I've actually emailed the developers and see if there's a way I can start from the beginning. I'm gonna start a new season with a new team anyway, but I'd like to start from the beginning and show you how to build up to this. It's a fun process. But in the meantime, I'm going to show you this way. We're going to do an exhibition game, just to show you how the gameplay works. So I'm going to be going on and on about how all of the great features this game has. And I don't care, because I love this game so much. So the difficulty rating is so well thought out. It's a system called Ego. So you can do it one way, you just go overall... general difficulty from easy all the way up, casual, medium, tough, serious, hard, extreme, good luck, and impossible. I have played one game on, I think, 90, and I think I actually won. Right now I'm kind of sitting right around the 80 to 83 kind of mark, but the amazing part is you'll see, as I found, there are various parts of your game that you're better at, some you kind of suck at, or take longer to develop. So you can alter the ego mode and actually make certain aspects of the game harder and some of it a little easier as you improve, which is awesome because I think batting is the hardest thing in this game, especially in the higher levels of difficulty. But I think I have everything else at 85 and the hitting at 80, and I can leave it there, I think. So you can totally customize. No, I shouldn't say totally. You can customize your team. You earn contracts through playing seasons, and you use those contracts to hire coaches, buy gear, hire trainers and also the stylists, and they all provide bonuses to fielding, throwing, speed, batting, or sorry, power, contact, running, all kinds of stuff. And then there's pitchers, which they've got velocity, they've got level of junk they can throw, like quality of junk, accuracy, all kinds of stuff. So, excuse me, we can't get into that today because that's only for seasons. And I looked into it, and if we start a new season with the team I have, because I'm level 81, I have 38 contracts to dole out, and that will take forever. I may or may not actually just do a video showing how that works and do that, but that could be like a half an hour video at least. Not doing much this weekend, I might get around to it, but we'll see. Anyway, so my boys are Moonstars, and when you customize your team, you can customize the names, I think you can customize the uniforms a little bit, you can customize how they look, like their physical features. And so when you do that, you kind of give each one its own version of itself, its own profile. And anyone who is a fan of Baseball Stars knows that the American Dreams are the best. I haven't named my team after the American Dreams. When I start a season for you guys, I think I might just do that. The names in this game are actually part of the humor, comic relief. They're actually pretty funny, so we'll show you some of those as well. Okay, let's move on. So I'll be my American Dreams. I'll have my ego set. Actually, I don't play the Sirloins. They're hard. Moonstars, American Dreams. Let's play the Buzzards. Sure. Okay, I like that. And they have a variety of fields. This one here kind of has versions of the Green Monster from Fenway Park. Kind of short to left and right field, but high walls. And they're just beautiful. The detail is amazing. Kind of a night-based stadium. Then there's Sakura Hills, which is pretty. Then there's kind of like almost like a sandlot style, but a stadium. So yeah, and I think there's like way more options in the sequel, which again, I am so stoked to play. And now that I got my new system, have I mentioned that yet? I bought a new computer and this is my first recording on it, and I'm super excited. I'll put the specs in the description for those that are interested. So let's play, I don't know. Pick something, Jeff. Okay, let's play in the motor yard. So there are your stats: power, contact, speed, fielding, and arm. Speed applies to both base running and running in the field. Fielding is catching the ball, you know, fielding ground balls, all that kind of stuff. And your arm, well, arm is straightforward. And then you get into pitching, velocity, jump, accuracy. This is my absolutely pimped out team, and if I go back, yeah, the skill boost is on medium, so that, like, it amplifies all the skills I already have, so most of them are pretty maxed out. And you have a bench, you also have a couple pitchers as well in the bullpen. I hope they put more pitchers. I find that two middle relief pitchers is not usually enough. Here we go, looking good. So the other great part of this game, among other things, is the mojo system. And that is actually the mood of each player. If you're in a slump, your mojo is low. And when your mojo is low, you perform less good in high-pressure situations, which the game also measures. If it's you're down by a run in the bottom of the ninth, then it's a 3-2 count. Your pressure is going to be absolutely extreme. And if you have low mojo, your chances of performing well are poorly. Are not good. So here we go. That's a stroke. So here's batting. You have a reticle. I don't know how that word is pronounced. And then when you need to line it up with where the pitch crosses the plate, and yeah. So in the easier egos, that target will actually just kind of follow the ball for you. As you get higher and higher, it doesn't move for you at all. You need to know where it's going to hit. Hitting A on the controller is a regular hit. If you want to do an extra power hit, you can use the right joystick. You pull back and you pull back and it gives you a number. I'm just showing you stuff. It makes it tougher to hit the ball, but if you do hit it, it crushes it. So, oh, Edge of Gobbleson. Yeah, if I can get a hit, I'll show you how this game works. And I swing at crap all the time. Herbert Hackman, let's go, Herb. Jeez, I haven't even touched the ball yet. All right.
No, that's high.
Good. And the umpires are finding this game too. Drop. Nope. All right, that's three out. Pitching is probably my favorite part of this whole game. So there are your selections on the right. Got your four seam, you got your two seam, screwball, changeup, forkball, curveball, slider, cut fastball, and a four seam fastball. The arrows tell you where the direction the ball is gonna go. Based on how much your junk ability, it'll move farther and farther and that kind of stuff. So there are two buttons to push. You choose one when you're pitching. You can hit A and it does a regular pitch, or you can do B and it does like a super pitch kind of thing. There's a scale of 0 to 100 as the quality of the pitch. And also, there's a target that comes up. The closer you get to the target, the higher the quality of the pitch. And the higher the quality of the pitch, the harder it is for them to hit it. Just like in regular baseball, if you aim for a fastball outside, or you aim for a slider to go up, hit the outside corner, but it winds up right there in the middle of the plate, they're going to crush it. So you make a mistake and you pay for it. So here we go. So I'll show you what I mean by this target thing. So you hold down X, and so the circle target is what you're aiming for, and the X is what moves, but you've only got a split second to put it there. So 59 is decent. Anything over 70 is usually pretty good. When you use the regular pitch button, so when you use A, it slows the X down, but the best you can do is 70. With X, it's a super pitch, the best you can do is 99. So, let's see how we do here. Go foul! So now, look at the bottom corner. So the hitter's mojo is quite low. The pressure is high for some reason in the bottom of the first, go figure. But I guess it's a full count. So she gets worried. So you see the black lines on her bars. Her actual yellow bars are lower than her natural stats because she's in a slump, she's not feeling very good, and she's afraid, basically. And she strikes out, and then see her mojo goes down by 10. So if you strike out, if you ground out, fly out, get hit by a pitch, thrown out stealing, if you do something wrong, you lose mojo. If you do something good, you gain it. Home runs give you like anywhere between 10 to 25 mojo. As pitchers, if you walk someone, you lose a couple. Strikeouts gain you some. I think just getting regular outs doesn't actually bump it up anything, but strikeouts definitely give you some. And it's a wonderful system, and it works really well. Okay, Geronimo James. And my dogs are barking now. Still barking. And so when you feel the ball, throwing bar comes up, and you want to get as high as you can, obviously. Let's throw a fork ball. And sick change. High heat. So the great thing about this game is there's many great things. When you're fielding, the buttons on the Xbox controller, when you have the ball in the field, each button represents a base. So if you want to throw it to first, you hold down the button that's in the first base position. And as the ball is coming to you on the ground, you can hold it down before it even gets to you, and that programs your fielder to throw it there once he's got it. So you can plan ahead kind of thing, and they're still barking. Sorry. All right.
Oh, outside. Oh, that's all.
Ah, popped it up. So you see, power 74. So, well, he got under it and popped it up. If he had made full contact with it, he would have hit it a lot harder than normal. All right, back to the mound. Yeah. There's two. How about a sick changeup? Got him. Dano Yoshida. Swinging curve. Yeah. So the computer will chase jump, will chase balls in the dirt at times. You don't have to always throw strikes. Obviously, you want to try and throw some good pitches, but pitching is a real art in this game, and you have to be good at it in order to win. Oh, he almost had it. And somebody did that. So you can dive, you can jump. All kinds of things that normal baseball games you can do. Oh, double play. Got him! So, whenever I'm hitting, if my guy has a higher contact bar than a power, usually I'll just go with a normal hit. Just use the A button. Can't confirm this, but I think the actual target, like if you see the gray part there, I think that is the power target, so it's smaller. I don't know that for sure, that's just a guess. Oh! Knocks it down, hell of a play. And a great thing about this game as well is the pace. Some baseball games anyone who's not a big fan of baseball, like watching it on TV, knows that it's a long game, and there's long pauses between each batter and each pitch and all that kind of stuff. And I get it. That's not for everybody. I love the game. I always have. But, you know, when I was a kid, sometimes playing a baseball game on a console would take, you know, 40 minutes to an hour just because of various factors, loading screens, all that kind of stuff. This game, a game in here, not even game, won't take you more than 20 minutes. Almost every time. This transition is so fast, and it's great. See? Just like that. Let's throw a change. Got a hold of that one. Oh, what is wrong with my fielders? Usually they're quite good at this. And you can also tap the button you want to throw it to. And it'll do a quick, toss, which is what you want to do when you're kind of turning double play and you're already close to the bag. Alright, let's see what we can do here. Stealing. Got him! So, one drawback to the game is you can't, and I think this is being addressed, I'm pretty sure, for the sequel. You can't adjust where your infielders are standing. So if there's a runner on third and less than one out, you can't move the infield in to try and prevent the run from scoring. The developers are super open to all the feedback, and they listen and take it very seriously. And they will reply to comments left on the Steam page or wherever. Like, they'll reply very frequently. And base hit. Base hit to center. I want to show you a home run, but I hope I get it. Yeah, that's not quite gone. Deep in the gap. Got it. Had a guy, Wendy. Alright. Top of the order. I think he's pitching a no-hitter on me here. Like I said, Ego 80 is hard. stay fair! Damn it.
Nope, that's inside. That's inside.
Confident. Damn it. Another thing that I have noticed frequently that I love about this game is nothing's predictable. And what I mean by that is, in a lot of the baseball games I grew up on and have played, you know, you hit the ball and you know what's going to happen right away based on, you know, preset trajectories and the programming, or, you know, even in this one, like, there's decent hit, there's good hit, there's fantastic, or sorry, decent contact, good contact, and I think awesome contact or something like that, and you can hear it, like, it goes thunk or it goes push. Even when you make great contact, it isn't necessarily going to be a hit or even a home run. I think I've had a home run on decent contact, like down the line kind of thing. So, it's unpredictable what's going to happen in this game. There's the variety is endless. Damn it. And the animation is pretty great too. Excuse me. Lots of talking tonight. Oh, go! Go! Deep, dead center, and gone! So it gives you the footage. 4.26. I've only ever hit one home run over 500 feet. But it can be done. So plus 14 mojo. Yeah, I love this game. Home runs are off. Home runs feel so good. Oh, that is going to be two for sure. Very fortunate error. Errors can happen at any time to anyone. And often at the most inopportune times. Yeah, errors happen on the computer. It does. So what are some of the games I grew up on? I grew up on... Oh, go! Deep right center... Oh, top of the wall. If it hit the brick wall over the yellow line, that's a home run. Just a top of the wall. I grew up on Baseball Stars, RBI Baseball 1, 2, and 3, I think, are the ones I played. Tommy Lasorda Baseball for Sega Genesis. That's kind of a... No one's ever heard of that one, but actually one of my favorites. Super Baseball Simulator 1000. Love that game. Kind of a comedy one, like you can throw, like, it's almost like magic. Whatever, go check it out. What else did I play? Bases Loaded, Super Bases Loaded. Didn't play Sports Talk Baseball for Genesis. I didn't play much baseball after, you know, the 64 bits started coming out. I don't remember playing any baseball on Nintendo 64. This is the first one I've ever owned on a PC. Jump! Ah, oh, close. Did I play anything on... I played a lot of golf games on PS2. PS1.
Ball outside.
Hot shots golf. That's that one's for you, Andy. Maybe we should play that. Yeah, I think that's most of them. But Bases Loaded or Baseball Stars was just the game growing up. It was the first customizable one where you could actually, like, buy power up points for your team, and, you know, actually grow your team and improve it. And I have no outs yet. Okay, I need to start focusing here. Shit. And that's a home run. Okay, well, too much talking gets your ass kicked. I just watched a video actually tonight, the latest release of the sequel for this game, and the level of customization is off the charts. They can customize everything about a uniform, everything about each player, your team name, your team uniform, your team logo, the number of teams in your division in a league, the number of teams in your conference. That's what the focus was for that video, was that kind of stuff. The biggest request from fans of this game for the sequel is online play, which is not available with this one, unfortunately. I know that's a huge undertaking for a developer, so I'm quite certain that they're including it this time around. It would be so awesome to have like leagues going with friends all over the world. Got it! Go! Yeah. Another funny thing about... I see those videos of people that like rage, you know, MMOs or something like that, and you know, the 360 no scope kind of thing or whatever it is, like, and people throwing controllers and breaking TVs and, you know, throwing monitors out the window, and I laugh at those guys. I don't rage at video games very often. I have raged really, really hard at this game, and I mean to the point where I'm surprised I haven't caused property damage. I won't get into the specifics, as it may incriminate me, but just like, you know, you throw some game, and I think what's behind that is the baseball games I watched or played growing up, once you kind of get a feel for, you know, patterns and, you know, understanding, there aren't too many variables, too many mechanics to master in those, you know, 8-bit, 16-bit games. So, you know, swinging on, and plus most of those were 2D, right? So there's only outside and inside pitches. There's no high or low. It was all timing. It wasn't necessarily placement of the swing. So I never, you never expect to lose in those kind of games as you get good at them. You know, you start a league, and or you start a tournament or whatever, or a league, and you go, you know, 25-0 because, you know, you've mastered it. It doesn't matter how good you are at this game. The ego is high enough, and you could throw a perfect fastball or curveball on the bottom outside part of the plate in the bottom of the zone at 99, and they can still crush it for a home run. There's something they can do about it, and oh yeah, turns on a high inside pitch. That is so gone. So look at the physics, like everything is just, it's perfect. It's, I love everything about this game. Except the fact that you can't move the infield. That bugs me. But yeah, like just playing baseball video games growing up, and you know, even playing them now, like I expected to win. When you have so few variables that a computer can throw at, like a AI can throw at you, you know, and it's 2D, like there's just not a lot of uncertainty, not a lot of things to think about, and you know, you find loopholes, and there's none of that in this game. You put the ego at 80 or 85, you will not go undefeated in a league. Simple as that. You're gonna lose. And that took time for me to understand. And I've self-admitted I have a problem with swinging at the first pitch because all the time and hit either popping it up because it's usually a bad pitch, and spent most of my life swinging at the first pitch because if it's over the plate, all you gotta do is time it in a 2D baseball game and you hit it. So there's a lot of this game is fun to play, and you know, you get your satisfaction pretty quickly, but it's tough to master. It is hard. but the difficulty scale is so well thought out and so well done. You set that barrier, that eagle bar too high, and bring it down. You know, if you're not, it's not fun anymore, bring it down. So it's great. I think you can even change eagle in game. Can you? I could be wrong in that.
Great.
Seriously, if you're a baseball video game fan, go buy this game. Hey, a Mojo plus 7, I got hit. That doesn't happen very often. Go buy this game. It's worth every single penny. Yeah, pitchers still suck at me. So, see, good contact, you get points for every good thing you do. So, good contact, but not good enough. So, tie game into the seventh. So, Alicia's stats are weaning. Her stamina bar is low, so I'm actually going to bring in a mid reliever. Burger-er. Some heat at the knees. Oh, he's nervous. I'm gonna fool him with a dirty changeup.
That's low.
Or not. How about a sweeping slider?
Outside.
All right. Oh shit. Oh, frozen. Usually, if your pitch quality is below 40, it's expect trouble. On this high of, see, look at that, 94. Super high quality pitch, and he just cranked the shit out of it. Hit about 390 feet. This computer will beat you. And it's kind of liberating. And infuriating at certain times. And anyone who comments below and says that, you know, MLB 16 or 17, whatever, is the best game ever, I will fight you. I disagree.
Right.
Maybe the most realistic interpretation of a baseball game. This is the best one. See, I'm such a dupe. I'm such a dope. I don't know why I always keep swinging at those things. Oh, that's why. Deep center field. Clear the wall. Top of the brick wall. 450 feet. The replay action. That's a beat. Lucky Lester. So, see, you see Elwood's stats are going down. His speed's gonna dwindle, and the break on his curveball is gonna get flatter.
Strike!
Ah, popped it up.
Yeah.
What do you get for not paying attention? Close this out. Overreach. Some of the forkball in the dirt. Got him! So Mojo up. So I think if you fail, like if you get out in a high pressure situation, I think your Mojo goes down even farther. It's a real slippery slope. Mojo is tough to get. There are also upgrades you can buy or contracts you can spend to increase your minimum Mojo, I guess. But that takes up a spot for something you can crank up your power. So it's a balancing act, which I may do a video in showing you how that works. Two down. You got a hold of that one. So look at that. So it's his team's down by two, bottom of the eighth, two strikes, two out. His mojo's low, and he's freaking the fuck out. And I doubt he's gonna. The last guy worked the fork ball on the dirt. I'll take that. Top of nine. Okay, now I'm gonna pinch it early for the pitcher. Pepe.
Nope, outside.
Get points for two balls in a row.
Outside.
Alright. Yeah, it got under it. How far will it go? Warning track. Ah. See, it's the first pitch habit. I can't seem to break it. All right, he's bringing a new pitcher. I'm bringing in a new hitter. Gustav Gustafson. This is my juice. This is my steroid monkey. This guy hits the ball a ton when he hits it. And because he only pinch hits, his mojo is off the charts. So if I get two strikes, I'll do it on purpose here. See, look at his stats. Now he's confident. Now he's jacked. He's sweating, but he's jacked. He got under that one. Maybe it'll curl foul. Maybe it won't. Alright, bottom nine. Bring in Lil Bupton. This is my Mariano Rivera. As it were. This is my boy. No lead is safe. Take three, I dare you. Alright. Gotta work around a leadoff double. We're in lineup. So number six hitter. Shit. I could very easily lose this game. I'll give him second. Alright. My god! Okay, that's... Oh, got him! I don't know what he did there. Well, it's six. Holy fuck. What? Why did... Okay, that's really strange. The runner on third didn't score. Why? That's really strange. I can't explain that one. There's no reason... It was a single. There's no reason why he shouldn't have scored. Holy crap. Man, should I walk this guy? Yeah, if I lose, it loses. It's only exhibition. It's only exhibition. So look at this guy. So look at his stats. He's in the zone. That's as high as you can get. That's as confident as you can get.
Outside.
I was not outside. See if he chases a changeup outside. Oh, I got him! Oh, man. That was huge. Okay, he's nervous. Can I pull this off? Oh, he's the winning run at the plate. Try a sweeping slider from inside. You can take second. Oh! Ball game! Wow, I can't believe I pulled that off. So, that's super mega baseball. Oops, I'll show you the stats. So, scoreboard, what did we get? got nine, six runs on nine hits, three homers. They got 12 hits, most of them singles. And your pitching lineup, or pitching line, six innings for Alicia, five strikeouts. Get your three stars. Rusty Bustin, he's my man. Like, in my season, which is now deleted, but that's okay. When I play a season, he's always, like, the Triple Crown winner. He's always batting 400 plus, tons, and, like, home runs out the yin-yang kind of things. So then you get points. So, as you notice, every time you do something good, even just making contact, you get points. And the higher the ego, the higher the multiplier of, the, of those points. And the more points you get, the more contracts you unlock. And as you gain levels, you unlock new and better modifiers. There's bronze, silver, and gold version of each modifier, and each one's better than the last. So, well, this video has gone off long enough, I'm sure. I actually didn't set a timer for this one because I didn't care. But I love this game, and I look forward to doing a season, and hopefully you guys will be interested in it. So, I can't stress this enough. If you like a baseball game, baseball video game, go buy this game. It's worth it. I love it, and I think you will too. So, I am Shmini300. I'm the Pure Gamer. Thanks for stopping by. Nice to see you. Have a great weekend, everybody. And as always, be kind, be strong, and be awesome. You are awesome. You're all awesome. Love you guys. See you soon.